Now, another problem using Factor Theorem. Factorize fx equal to x cube minus 6x square plus 11x minus 6. A polynomial given, we want to factorize this using Factor Theorem. How can we use this Factor Theorem? Using Factor Theorem, we can find the zeros of this polynomial. If fa equal to 0, then a is a 0. If a is a 0, x minus a is a factor. So thus we can find all the zeros and all the linear factors. This is a cubic polynomial, third degree polynomial. And therefore this will have only three linear factors in the form x minus a, x minus b, x minus c. Three linear factors. So find all the three linear factors using this factor theorem. And now consider the polynomial. This polynomial is one with all coefficients integers, integral coefficients. And the leading coefficient is 1. Therefore, by the integral root theorem, that a result we have seen, integral root theorem, the roots of the polynomial equation or the zeros of this polynomial are factors of the constant term an. Constant term here an is minus 6. Factors of minus 6. So what are the possible factors of minus 6? Factors of minus 6 are plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3, and plus or minus 6. These are the possible factors of the constant term minus 6. That means the zeros are from these collection of values, numbers, this collection. Then we verify one by one what are the zeros, actual zeros. That is, find f1, if it is 0, x minus 1 is a factor. Similarly, find f minus 1, f2, f minus 2, f3, f minus 3, so on, till we obtain all the three linear factors. If we obtain the three linear factors, then there we can stop the verification, checking. So here, now we verify f1, f minus 1, etc. for 0. Then consider this, f1 is equal to, function is x cube minus 6x squared plus 11x minus 6. So this is equal to 1 cube minus 6 into 1 squared plus 11 into 1 minus 6, which is equal to 1 cube 1 minus 6 plus 11 minus 6, which is equal to minus 6 minus 6 minus 12, 1 plus 11, 12. So minus 12 plus 12, which is equal to 0, which means this x minus 1 is a factor. X minus 1 is a factor. Now consider this f minus 1. F minus 1 is equal to minus 1 cube minus 6 into minus 1 squared minus plus 11 into minus 1 minus 6, which is not equal to 0 because all these four terms are negatives. This is negative, this is negative, this is negative, this is all negative. So a negative number, so not equal to 0. So we see that this x plus 1 is not a factor. Since f minus 1 not equal to 0, x plus 1 is not a factor. And now consider this f2. F2 is equal to this 2 cube minus 6 into 2 squared plus 11 into 2 minus 6, which is equal to 2 cube 8 minus 6 into 4 minus 24 plus 11 into 2, which is equal to 22 minus 6. Which is clearly equal to 0. 8 plus 22, 30, minus 24, minus 6, minus 30. So this is equal to 0. So x minus 2 is a factor. X minus 2 is a factor. Now consider this f of minus 2, which is equal to minus 2 cube, minus 6 into minus 2 squared, plus 11 into minus 2, minus 6, not equal to 0. Here also all these four terms are negative. This is negative, this is negative, this is negative, this is negative. So not equal to 0. And now consider this F3 is equal to this 3q minus 6 into 3 squared plus 11 into 3 minus 6, which is equal to 3 cube 27. Then minus 6 into 3 squared, 3 squared 9, 6 minus 54. Then 11 into 3, which is 33 minus 6, which is equal to 0, because this 33 plus 27, 60, minus 54, minus 6, minus 60, 60, minus 60, which is equal to 0, which shows that this x minus 3 is a right. So this has only 3 linear vectors. You have obtained these 3 vectors, linear vectors, and therefore you obtained all the 3 vectors. So there we stop the verification, not proceed. And now we obtained the linear vectors. And then how will you write this polynomial expression? This fx is equal to this x cube minus 6x squared plus 11x minus 6. And can we write this in the form? This x minus 1 into x minus 2 into x minus 3. We know this polynomial will have 3 linear factors, first degree factors, but we do not know whether there is any constant, which is not linear, but it is a constant with the degree 0. There can be a constant with respect to this product. So we do not know whether there is a constant or not. So we place a constant there. And comparing these two, let's say, right, say, we can find the value of k. Equating coefficient of x cube from both sides. Here coefficient of x cube is 1. Here also coefficient of x cube is k, which is from left side 1. Coefficient of x cube in the right side k, left side 1. So k equal to 1, and therefore we see that this is equal to this x cube, this x minus 1 into x minus 2 into x minus 3. So this is the factorization of the given polynomial. Okay?